Alright, welcome to my video, which is about elements. You know, those science things that stuff made. Like, it's actually atoms. It's a kind of atom. And, like, yeah, I made a ranking of them because no one made a ranking of those before. And, like, you know, it's a top 10 best of and worst of. So, yeah. Let's see. Ah, yeah, there it goes. Alright, first of all, the top 10 elements, the best of. Just the top 10. First, number 10 is titanium. I mean, it's pretty cool, but overrated. It's like, solid titanium, the indestructible supermaterial. And I heard it's actually destructible. It's like, overrated, but not bad. Next, number 9 is molybdenum, or however it's pronounced. It's got like a hilarious name, and seems to be an actual metal, rather than a weird gas or liquid or like actually death or something. So yeah, it's okay, good enough for number 9. Then I got krypton, which is like what Superman farts. I don't know what it actually is, except that it's a gas and it sounds like the kryptonite stuff that Superman is allergic to, except that it's a crystal or something. I don't know, I've only seen like one Superman movie, and there's a whole bunch of that stuff that the bad guy, what's his name, I don't know, Martin Luther, no, that's not him, that's the guy who destroys the Catholic, but you know, the bad guy from Superman, he made buy a whole bunch of that stuff to stop Superman. Alright, number 7 is helium. You know, it makes you speak like a Mickey Mouse. I could try that, but I won't, because this is a terrible video. It also makes like balloons float. Both those, like, small, decorative, funny children's party balloons, but also, like, big hot air balloons, or, like, even zeppelins, or however, those, like, there's a weird English term for it. I forgot what it was again. Blimp, right, you know, those big things, you can put ads on them. I read that they're actually a really good mode of transportation, but, you know, don't know shit. Like, trains are good, too. So, let's go on to copper. Yeah, I mean, it's good. Like, you can use it for, it's made into wires, which are useful. It's supposedly worth enough that people steal it, and it's also the weird guy in the Big Bang Theory. So yeah, bazinga. Next is iron, which, you know, I talked about with helium. I like trains. And you know what train tracks are made of? Iron. That's why in German it's called Eisenbahn. The Eisen is German for iron. It's like useful, you can make steel of it. It's a good material for things like, I don't know, tools. And you can make like iron for ironing your shirts. It's a solid material. Literally, it's pretty solid. It's not a gas, it's a solid. And yeah, it's decent, but not outstanding. Next, I got hydrogen, which is like half water, half weird super fuel. I mean, water is good, but water is also, it's like, it's also got, it's like H2O, so it's got one oxygen and two hydrogen in it, which, I mean, it means it's mostly hydrogen, but not, like, hydrogen, it's kinda cool, you can use it as fuel too, and all kinda, it's not bad, but yeah, I don't know. There's better too, but there's a lot worse. And, you know, water is good. Supposedly the body is made of like 80% water. Or like some vegetables are a lot of water. You drink water all the time. Everything. It rains water. The clouds are made of water. You know, stuff that's around a lot. Usually it's cool. Like, I like swimming, which requires water. Now, to go on, I got lithium, which is number 3. It's cool, like, mobile batteries, they're made of it. Other stuff is probably also used in, but I got no clue about it. I only know that it's used in mobile phone batteries, which are pretty good. Like, are they actually that good? I mean, they hold, like, a day, which is enough. But still, it could be better. Like, if you're out for a really long day, it can run short if you're actually using it too much. But then again, it's manageable, and like, from what I know, it's actually that they are getting really a lot better, but also then they're just making the phones use more power, because they're cramming in, I don't know, a 17 megapixel giga camera with a drone, and I don't know, they are cramming so much things that also use power into it that it's not actually as useful. Oh, also I just saw that in the corner there, you can see the mouse, it actually says the number of the page, which is confusing because that's also the numberings of the ranks. So yeah, now I got number 2, aluminium, which is like iron except better. I mean, iron, it's like sure, it's good, but aluminium is like basically, from what I understand, it's what all it can do everything that iron does without being heavy, and it's also not conductive to electricity. Which, I mean, why would you have iron be conductive to electricity when you can just use copper for it? It just means everything, if you touch anything made of iron, you may die from an electric shock. You know, it's actually like, and I think it's actually a lot of better for it to not be conductive to electricity, because that just means it means you can't die from it. Well, not like that anyway. So yeah, I got materials. They make planes of it, which I'm not that big a fan of, but other stuff too. It's like metal, but not heavy shit like iron. Like iron obviously has its uses. I mean, I like the Eisenbahn, so trains, but still. Now, let's go on to number 3, which is air. I mean, oxygen. Oxygen, air, same deal. Like, air is literally O2, which is two oxygen stick together. I don't remember a lot from chemistry, but that's how it worked, I think. And I didn't find a picture because air, you can't see it. And it's actually like, that part I remember. It's like 70% nitrogen, which I don't have on the list at all. Plants use it, it's in the air, but it's overall boring. And like to the 20% or something air, the oxygen, that's interesting, that's the part that's cool. But now go on to the, let's go on to the best one, the best element, number 1, and that's obviously carbon. Now carbon, basically everything is made of it. Here, this is some guy, apparently that's a Walking Dead episode, and that's what it says when I googled some guy. I don't know, I just meant that some guy, as in literally everyone, is made of carbon. You know, they can make those safety shoes, which usually used to be have steel caps here, protecting your toes. They can make it from carbon too, like super carbon nano shit. Coal, I mean, I'm no fan of coal at all, but you can make a lot of shit from it. It's like used everywhere. It can be used in all kind of ways. Like this is why I wrote nanotube shit here. I couldn't find a good pictures of it, so you know, nano cyber carbon thingy is like the super material, you know, that's really great and everything. Like that's all carbon, and like the body is supposedly made of 80% water, but the carbon that's holding it in, I guess, or not. I'm really terrible at the sciences, but yeah, it's a good material. I like it. Now let's go on for the top worst elements. I didn't actually rank them because like I'm bad at math and I hate counting and it was kinda annoying, and also I was too lazy to figure out that many bad elements, so it's just a random ranking. All of them are kinda bad or pretty bad. Actually the first one is pretty bad. It's actually two, plutonium and uranium. You know, uranium is funny because it sounds like they named it after Uranus, which is funny, but really it's terrible. Like you make nukes from it, which are terrible. It kills you with radiation, which is terrible. You can use it for power plants too, which sometimes just explode, and then you can't live in the whole region. Overall, terrible materials. Should stay away from them. Seriously, they are bad news. All things considered, they are like, I don't know, put them in a, I don't have a clue what to do with them, but stay away from them, I guess. And sorry. Now, next on gold and platinum, which are like the most valuable materials, and you know, they are overrated. They are really overrated. Are they really useful? Eh, rarely. There's like a few things you can do with them, but not really. They are kinda shiny, but honestly, they are just overrated, which is why they are bad. Like, they are not like titanium, which is overrated, but still pretty good. No, they're just overrated. They are basically shiny rocks. Well, are rocks metals? I'd actually say rocks aren't metals, but I don't have a clue how this shit works, science-wise, so Yeah, I do know that gold and platinum, they're totally overrated. Now the next one is mercury. It's actually got a totally different name in German. I forgot what it was, but yeah, it's just in thermometers, and it's like really unhealthy. Like basically, it's poison. It has literally one good use. I don't know. Maybe it has more, but I only know one good use in thermometers, which are okay, I guess. But you know, for things that's poisonous, it could be a lot better to make up for it. So like this, it's just bad. The next one too, it's Californium, and it's like I don't have a clue what it is. I don't have a clue at all. Yeah, but they named it after California, which, I mean, I've never been there, but it seems like pretty arrogant. Like, why would you name something after California? They already have all the things. Like they have pretty, like they have Los Angeles, which is pretty big. The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air is set there. You know, like Hollywood is there in general. It's got all the shit. Why name a material you discover after it? Seems like a dick move. They should have probably named it after, I don't know, Einstein 2. So like Einsteinium 2 or some of the other scientist guys, Planck or whatever. Now there's Darmstadtium, which is the same but worse. Why the fuck would you name something after Darmstadt? I've never been there. It's somewhere in the south of Germany. It's a shitty-ass town. It's Darm is actually I forgot what the English word is, but the part it's actually part of the digestive system. You know, if you eat something, it first gets in the I forgot the oh damn it, I forgot all the words. Like in the stomach part, where all the acids are and dissolve it. You know what I mean, hopefully. And then it goes into the Darm. I forgot the English word, I'm sorry. But yeah, that's the part of the digestive system where all the good stuff is taken out, and at the end the shit remains. And the Stadt part, that's just city. It's like the worst name. Why would you name a city like that? And then why would you go on name an element after it? Totally a big mistake, honestly. And I don't even know, like, is there any useful application, or is it like one of those weird vanity as elements that like exist but don't actually do anything useful except like existing or being able to exist, but not really. Now we got phosphorus, which is used in which can be used for war crimes. That's what I remembered about it. Like white phosphorus is pretty bad, I think, like in several ways. I don't actually know anything about it, to be honest. But yeah, war crimes are bad, like really bad, obviously. And yeah, this might have been in bad taste. In fact, this probably is in bad taste. I should probably have left this out. Now, the selenium. Pretty sure that's poisonous. Next, there's arsenic. Yeah, that's definitely poisonous. It's like the one of the number one poison elements. It's also called like arson. And then there's americium, which is bad because like that's to America, you know, stops the American imperialist apparatus. It's like America. It's just bad, and therefore, and the element after it is obviously also bad. So yeah, this guy. Well, this is obviously a racist cartoon, but basically. Death to America. That's something I can subscribe to. The American state needs to be abolished by the American people. They need to get rid of the shackles of the American states, get rid of the American ruling class, and also get rid of this guy. He's whack. But, like, you know, America is bad. Now, there's some honorable mentions or the things that are good and bad, but I couldn't really decide. So, yeah, let's go on. Let's have a look at them. Now there's silicon. It's like Silicon Valley. It's terrible. There's all the weird, crazy ass Silicon Valley people there, which is bad enough. But you know, computers are useful, and I think there's not actually any silicon in Silicon Valley except in the computers. It's like called after it because of a. Well, it's like obviously they do stuff with computers, but they don't actually. I don't have a clue, but Silicon Valley is bad. Computers are useful though. So yeah, you can think about it what you want. I mean, you can both, like, you can do both. You can flood Silicon Valley while also using computers still. I mean, it's not like Silicon Valley is where there's the one mine where they can get computers. It's like totally overrated, totally bad. Not overrated. This isn't over. Well, it's also overrated, but it's just bad, evil. Next on, there's Neon. I like it, honestly, but I got told that it's boring. So yeah, like, neon lights seems like a cool idea. They seem cool. Neon colors, they seem pretty cool too, especially on markers. But also, it's supposedly boring, so I don't know. I mean, some neon colors are also terrible, I guess. And we got lead. It's like poisonous and bad, but it can be used to protect you from radiation, so yeah, that's what makes it less bad. Like, as I said from some of the other things, you know, if it has both good and bad characteristics, that makes it more useful. And like lead, it can let you neutralize some of the terrible effects of uranium and plutonium. So that's like, it's got upsides and downsides, and you just gotta use it the right way. Like, you can't just put something else around it, and then you have a shield from radiation that also doesn't kill you when you lick it, because you can't directly lick it. Why would you lick it anyway? But, you know, if it gets on your skin, it's probably bad, which is why you just put a layer next to it that prevents just that from happening. And thank you for listening. Obviously, and this is a final rating. This is how the elements which are good, which are bad. That's how it is now. It has been decided. According to pretty good standards. I mean, you know, carbon is pretty good after all. And nuclear annihilation is pretty bad after all. So yeah, thank you for listening. Now, here are my sources. Wikipedia.org, which is actually, I didn't actually use it a lot, I just used it for the periodic table of elements, and then I used Google Images, where I got the images from Google. You know how it works. So yeah. Now how can I actually end this? Alright, stop recording.